Hello, Chicago. It is really nice to be here, and you really should all be congratulated for hosting an event like this, which is unique to the world of architecture, at least in my experience. And I feel like I'm a little bit in last man standing. We call our project Pierscape. Pierscape is a culmination of a lot of hard work by a lot of people, but it recognizes a unique civic opportunity which the project represents, and it goes far beyond a document called the Centennial Vision, which is very eloquently presented by Navy Pier. One thing I'd like to remark, really important to understand, is that Navy Pier is not broken. It functions well. It hosts nearly 9 million people a year. And what we can do is add a layer to make it function, go into the future with strength and I would say innovation. Pierscape, our project, is a play in five acts. A synthesis of the projects identified in the Centennial Vision, and we propose that we would expand this offer. Are you familiar with the five acts? Okay. The Centennial Vision proposes five. I guess I'm going to be the first, so I'm going to explain it. There are five principal projects outlined in the Centennial Vision. The first is to take a look at Gateway Park, which is at the west end of Navy Pier. It's the entrance threshold plaza. The second project would be the Crystal Garden, which you probably all know very well. The third being Pier Park. The fourth being the South Dock, which is that 3,000-foot expanse of space that runs along the south edge of the pier. And the fifth, of course, is the East End. So these five acts are terribly important to understand, and I've used three of my 25 minutes in order to bring us up to speed. Navy Pier is and can be and should always be a world-class destination, an integrated, coherent whole that is greater, obviously much greater than the sum of its parts. Our proposal, as you can see here, is complex but very well organized. It's feasible, it's scalable, and it's achievable. Gateway Plaza, at the west end, is a threshold experience, and as such, it is the transforming. It's where you disengage from the city of Chicago and enter the realm of the Navy Pier. We've designed in the center of the threshold entry sequence a wave pier, a wave fountain, which is designed by Ned Kahn, and to the south, a fantastic wetland experience, which we call the Scoop. The idea of threshold and the transformation from threshold to from one realm to another is that we would like to see the visitors to Navy Pier be able to escape. Therefore, the title Pier Escape. As we continue to the east, we leave Pier Park and we are into Pier Park, I'm sorry. And finally, Pier Park can become the productive partnership that they with the Crystal Garden that it really always should have been. And we think this is terribly important. The South Dock, which is this long, long expanse along the south edge, is the overall organizer of the of pier itself. It's the gatherer, it's the main public space, it's the route of procession. And we think that it should be used as a kind of a porch, and we call it the porch. It will have light towers, it will have kiosks, and it'll stretch to 3,000 feet from the east end all the way into the city of Chicago, perhaps even as far as North Michigan Avenue. Along the experience of the porch, we have the floating gardens, we have Boat Central, but the porch is, of course, the most important unifying element. We think that the South Porch should always be an outdoor experience. It should be open, free, and clear, as the Burnham quote reminds us. And at the end, the East End becomes a very important destination. We have, along the way, located elements which I think will entertain you, and we're going to go through these pieces at this point. Martha? Oh, it's Martha.
Good evening, Chicago. So this is going to be a very quick history of the city of Chicago in like 1 minute. Here's Navy Pier, right, at the base of the Great Lakes, the largest body of fresh water on the surface of the planet. Let's get this thing out of the way. Here, will you take that? And so here you can see how, since the beginning of the founding of Chicago, the shaping of the lakefront has really been an important part of the city's legacy, right? And this has been for three reasons. One, to secure the quality of the water, the life-giving waters of Lake Michigan. Number two, for economic development. Number three, and most importantly for us, the kind of creating space for the civic betterment of the people of the city. And so as Stephen was saying, you know, since the days of Burnham, we've had this idea of the lakefront as a space which is open, free, and clear. And we also imagine Navy Pier as being a kind of renewed jewel in the Emerald Necklace. And so since the beginning of Navy Pier, it was also really a hybrid. At first, a compromise between Burnham's dream of a recreational pier, again, for people, and the need for a modern port. But since the 1995 renovation, it's become closer and closer to realizing Burnham's original dream of a people's pier. And so we really see the Pierscape as being the next step in the realization of that dream. Martha?
Bob?
Bob. Looks like we're going to introduce ourselves. I'm Robert Bruckner. Marshall, if you can do the history of Chicago in a minute, I can do process in 30 seconds, I think. And I know there are three teams out here that know what that feels like. So very quickly, what we're going to do is just jump forward a little bit and talk about our giving period, which is when we were at our broadest point. Go back just one, Marshall, if you can. The grid of Chicago, a defining departure point for the geometry of the floating gardens, the orthogonal and the diagonal. The connection into the city from, I think as Steve mentioned, from Michigan Avenue all the way to East End. So there are some guiding truths that came out of the early design process, and they are, and you're going to hear them more than once, connecting the city to the pier, and connecting the city to the world, and the pier to the world, escaping at the pier, getting down to the water, reorienting all of this to the south, for the sun, for the city, and of course the water, and expanding the offer, and docking this offer in the water between the South Dock and the Dime Pier. So with that, I want to introduce Martha Schwartz. She's going to take you on a great walk.
Thank you. It's going to be a quick walk. So we'll go through the elements. This morning we had a walkthrough, but this is going to be a run through. Again, the five portions and destinations that Steve talked about. I won't go over that next. Let's start with the Gateway Park, which actually has three components. There is the entry plaza, the Gateway Plaza, there's the wetland scoop, and then there's the bus plaza. What we've done is we've actually respected the head house and the access by placing the fountain on that axis. This fountain is going to be an interactive wave fountain by Ned Kahn, and we have kept all the trees, so we have a recall of the history. Next, please. Okay, so the elements of the entry plaza start with this threshold wetland stream, so that when you cross over the stream, you know you have arrived to Navy Pier. It starts with a water wall that pumps water from the lake and goes down the stream and then heads south. We have a very nicely surfaced plaza that is really pedestrian oriented, and then the wave fountain by Ned Kahn. Next, please. And here is this stream that becomes both a kind of a stepping stones and a feature. Next, please. And the idea is that there would be, you know, thousands of nozzles that would actually create one big wave. It would be programmed to create a wave going from east to west that would be also able to be played in. Next, please. You head south from the plaza along the pathway, and you come to what we call the scoop. You walk down steps down into a space that we actually have hollowed out from the existing ground plane and have created a southern water wall that also brings the water from the wetland stream down into this wetland park and feeds us terraces like rice paddies that will be planted with wetland species that respond to a descending elevation down to a wetland floor. Next, please. The wetland floor will actually be a recreated wetland area that will you'd be able to walk through and experience. The idea here is that it will be a park for enjoyment and learning, and it will be curated as a vehicle for teaching children and the public about lakeside habitats and ecologies and connected to the Children's Museum. It will also function to detain and filter surface runoff. Okay, keep on going. All right, so finally, after you have had some peace and quiet in the scoop, the wetland area, you come up to the surface and you ramp up to this overlook that you behold the entire floating gardens, the porch, and Pier Park. And you decide, okay, this is where I want to go. This is how I'm going to spend the rest of my day. And you continue on down the porch.
So just a few more comments about the porch. In the amount of time that you've heard the word porch, what comes to mind? I think we all have memory of this. The porch is the face of the pier, and it's also the pathway from the city to the pier. It's defined by two very simple moves, one which is horizontal and one which is vertical. Sounds familiar, right? The light towers that are created are inspired, obviously, by the skyline and kind of work and collaborate with the skyline and the historic continuum of that skyline. They're slender stainless steel channels. Alone, they're scaled to an individual, and together, they form a scrim for the activity, the visual complexity, and the energy of the pier. At night, they present a unified and powerful image of the pier back to the city, and they illuminate the path both to and from.
Okay. The porch is 2,700 feet long and our dominant and the most important space of Navy Pier. It's an industrial-scale pedestrian promenade and the spatial organizer for all the new and proposed elements of Navy Pier. Our design calms and dignifies the irregularities of the existing architecture and provides formality, rhythm, and the armature into which all the activities and destinations are now docked. It creates a salubrious south-facing overlook to the water, the site of our major civic offer to Navy Pier, the floating garden, down here. Next, please. As we walk along the pier, we walk up to Pier Park along steps that we have created to be able to allow you to get up from the South Dock in a more graceful, happy way. It will be a place to meet and greet where people can hang out on the steps and actually sit and watch the water as well. Up to the surface of Pier Park, and you can see there is the flyover that now connects Pier Park down to the water and the play pier. Next, please. So you walk up the stairs, just you know, like the Spanish steps, it really becomes a social space, not a punishing kind of experience trying to get up. Next, please. So you come up to these steps and you are in front of the Shakespeare Theater. And the idea of Pier Park is that we have a language that actually engages and includes the Shakespeare Theater, the amusement area, and the Crystal Garden into one area. But what we have suggested is a series of outdoor spaces that are adjacent to the theater so that you can have theater outside and in with the amusements as well. Marshall, are you next? Yeah, Marshall, yeah. This is you.
But just stay here, Martha. It's
yeah,
fine.
All right.
Stay with me.
Okay.
So this is where we have some fun. So the upper level of Pierscape is where we get high and go through the looking glass. The complex mixture, I mean, you don't all know this, but there's a really complex mixture of rides, restaurants, catering, miniature golf, children's museum, the theater, the playscapes, plants, plus the magic, you know, the kind of atmospheric magic of Navy Pier, that culminate in one big idea for us, which is a veritable wonderland. So what Martha has created for us is really a landscape of giant toadstools and hillocks, a magical surprise anywhere, but especially within the flatness of Chicago, which we all know so well, even more so. And so this new topography actually provides a spatial drama between the below the kind of literal drama of the Shakespeare theater and the Ferris wheel. And so these themes actually continue into the Crystal Garden, where we're asked, well, how will this conservatory, how will this greenhouse be different from all the other beautiful greenhouses we have in Chicago? Well, the difference is simple. In this one, we grow magic mushrooms and giant beanstalks. Martha, you want to take over?
No. Okay. Yes, I mean, the idea is that we have two major spaces in the Crystal Garden. We have one space that is really devoted to children's play, and the other area is devoted to events. But the idea is the Playscape is really an environment for artists who deal with interactive play and learning and play. So it's going to be an art exhibit of play, play equipment as well. Next, please. We have a continuous surface made out of different materials, rubber, concrete, grass, turf, everything that really can roll into one surface. Next, please. As we walk out, we actually now can continue over the flyover and down to pier, play pier here. And the idea is that you now have a civic public open space with play that is now connecting to Pier Park. But the other thing is that you now can behold the view of the floating gardens. And this is our major new civic space. They are gardens on the water for play, culture, and relaxation. This expands the offer by allowing for a less commercially driven atmosphere that is truly civic space to be enjoyed by all. It allows for a variety of programs and activities. It creates more seasonality. It will create new reasons for people to come and stay longer, and will increase the range of people who really will want to come to Pier Park. It's an environment that doesn't yet exist in Chicago, which already has miles of gorgeous lake edge, but this experience is being on and in the water. The other important piece of this is that we have respected the historic footprint of a Navy Pier, and it celebrated 3,000 foot long heroic edge. We have created a series of docks that actually hinge onto the pier without really tampering with the strength of that edge and its industrial past. In fact, we have created a hybrid of pier and park that, instead of being an industrial barge, are docking onto the Navy Pier as a new kind of open space for Chicago. Okay, next, please. Okay, so here we have, we're at the flyover from Pier Park and come down into the Play Park. Next, please. The Play Park will have all sorts of activities, summer activities, climbing walls, swings, porches, all sorts of things will go on. It will be high octane and energetic in summer and in winter. And this is the actual, one of the other ramps that can be used for sledding. Next, please. The west area is our performance pier that is going to be devoted to outdoor performances, performance on the water, sunbathing, art exhibits, things that are really about culture and art. Next, please. And the easternmost pier, and this is, the whole thing is actually composed of three components that are actually separated but connected by bridges. This is the quiet pier where people can go to the beach, they can be more isolated, they can read a book, they can go swimming, get into the water. Next, please. And the scale of this and the intimacy is something that really relates to being out on the water and having some peace and quiet. Next, please. Okay, we have Terry? Where's Terry? Oh, there you are. Sorry. Okay, so Terry's going to show us, tell us how
to talk briefly about the construction and the unique qualities of doing a floating gardens or a floating pier. These were designed and thought of as a unique opportunity to apply tried and true marine engineering to support an over-the-water recreation area that is floating, not fixed. It's floating to keep it a fixed amount above the water level at Lake Michigan that fluctuates, but to get you down closer to the water than a fixed pier ever could. Pontoons are placed on guide piles that will be slipped so it allows the fluctuation up and down, and the pontoons allow the float and ballast under the water so that we can construct a very conventional galvanized steel and wood decking on top of the water. This allows us to do geometries of every slope, skew, slant, construct voids, pools, and stairs on the floating gardens and the floating pools, and they're ecologically sound because the only fixed impact on the lake would be the guide piles for this construction.
I'm told I have about 10 seconds. One of the biggest problems that we have along the south dock with the porch is the wall of boats. We have a wall of buildings and we have a wall of boats. So in order to support this notion of open, free, and clear, we have consolidated the boats into what we call boat central. It's an efficient way to reorganize the boats to support this critical revenue to the Navy Pier. And so we think this is a really great introduction in the process of the renovation. To the west, as you see, that sort of fuzzy east, rather, the fuzzy field. Marshall, can you point to it? This is what we call the wind field. This is a dynamic installation, which will also be by Ned Kahn. We're sure that it will be, it is made of a series of elements which respond to the wind, to the light, to the rain. During the day, it will reflect, and it will reflect the light from above. At night, it will reflect the light from below. And you can see the piece to the right is an example of a NEDCOM piece, and we think that this will become an absolutely world-class destination art event at the east end of Navy Pier. People will come from all over the world, and Martha's pushing me off the
stage. Yeah, sit down. Okay, great. All right. So here is our Blue Lagoon. It's a year-round public spa, a must-see, must-go experience that everybody will want to go to repeatedly. It's a place where you can come all seasons. Next, please. Get into the lake of Lake, into the water of Lake Michigan, even in the winter. It is a giant civic hot tub. The blue mist rising, glowing blue, will be a magnet to everyone who comes to Navy Pier. Next, please. This is looking at the people in the hot tub in the winter. Let's go. Next, please. So looking at the East Pier, we have the Blue Lagoon, we have the Lightning Pier, we have the Ballroom Pier here, and then we have the amphitheater that steps down into the water. Next, please. So here we have, again, touching very lightly against the edge of the East Pier is a wooden deck that steps down as an amphitheater into the water, where during the summertime it's a fountain that brings up lake water, and in the wintertime it's an ice skating area strewn with rocks and becomes an area for performance as well. But this is not the last act here. Bob?
What do you need, Steve, a minute? So throughout this very rapid presentation, you've seen little futuristic shapes kind of bubbling around. Well, imagine yourself in one of those bubbles. With our partner, Mark Sparfield, we've conceived of the pier pod, which would take you from East End up to the level of the Ferris wheel, perhaps back down again at the head house, over to DeSable Park, along the south bank of the Chicago River, you know, maybe as far as the Sears Tower, who knows. The idea of this is a simple one. It's a mode of arriving to the pier. It's a mode of departing the pier and connecting with perhaps one of the greatest constructed landscapes anywhere. And to do so as a spectacle, but to also do so as a mode of transportation. It would be a journey like no other, and it's a journey that we believe will be taken often. So with that, I want to turn it over to Stephen, and we'll close very quickly for you.
We don't expect to do the pier pod in the $85 million. Let me just conclude. The Pierscape expands the offer on many, many levels. The proposal, we believe, is world-class, as is Navy Pier. That it's a year-round proposal. It creates spectacle. It connects people with the water in an urban way, which we think is unprecedented, although it's been done before. It has a series of iconic civic spaces. It activates the East End, and most of all, Pierscape is all about Chicago. Thank you.